Hello, good morning everyone. Today we are going to review how to create an indicator and strategy using the strategy builder on InsiderTrader 8. For this example, we are going to use stochastic. On this indicator, we have two lines, the key and the D. We are trying to create a strategy that enters at the crossovers and also an indicator that paints the signals. For example, here we have a crossover with a long entry, another crossover for the short entry, a crossover to the upside for a long signal, and finally crossover to the downside for this short. To create this setup, we are going to use the strategy builder. On InsiderTrader 8, it is called strategy builder instead of strategy wizard. We assign a name, for example, stock crossover. We select if trading at bar close, if we need additional data, and then we specify the input parameters. One of the parameters is the period. I will use a default of 7. Then the smoothing with a default of 3. And as this is a strategy, I will also add a fixed target and a fixed stop. So when we optimize the strategy, we can also optimize by those parameters. So I will add the target input parameter with a default of 12. And finally, a stop input parameter with a default of 15. And now, with the four input parameters that will be available on the following dialogues, then when we can specify the conditions to enter long or short. When we have the conditions to enter long, I want to paint an arrow up. On the vertical position, I specify the high of the bar with a ticks offset of 4. This is a long signal, and for a long signal, it is better to place the signal below the bar. So instead of high, I will use the low of the bar with an offset, a negative offset of 4 ticks. So we place the marker 4 ticks below the low of the bar. On the formula, we can see that we are using low 0 minus 4 times the tick size. And the second command is the order execution. We want to enter long when the conditions are met. For the condition, this is the condition for a long, and when the stochastic, we must define the parameters of the stochastic. So we can use the input parameters, the period, and the smooth. I forgot to add the D line period. Then we select the key line, and we want to check when the key line crosses above the D line. So on the right panel, we select the same indicator with the same parameters, for the condition we choose cross above. So we place the same parameters. The period on the input parameters, the smoothing also from the input parameters, but now we select the D line. So we check when the key line crosses above the D line, and when that happens we can see the formula at the top. The two, we can copy that condition and paste it into another tab, so we don't have to type everything again. And this tab, for the short, we only need to change the cross above by cross below. For the actions, we can also use the copy, but on this case, instead of arrow ups, we want arrow downs. And for the vertical position, I want the arrows located from the high 4 ticks above. 4 ticks above the high of the signal bar. And the second action is to enter short. So we add the order management enter short. And now we have the two conditions. So we can click on next, and here we can set the target and stop. So for the profit, we can use a tick mode with the input parameter that we have defined. The same for the stop, we add a stop loss, also expressed in ticks, defined by the input parameter stop. So now we are ready to finish. And now we can apply that strategy to the chart. So we will get orders and markers over the chart. When we apply the strategy, we can see the input parameters that we have defined with the default settings. Now we click on OK. And then from the control center, we can enable the strategy from the strategies tab. And we can see all the executed orders. We can check if they are well aligned with our signals. Here we have a short, a long, and finally this short. Here we have another long, and here a short. We can get the strategy performance for the historical results. And on this report, we can get a lot of useful information. More of that on another video. Something that we can see is that we only get a painted signal for the last long and the last short, not for all the signals. This was not happening on Ninja 7. We can see what we need to edit when we edit the code to convert this to an indicator. First, we open an editor. edit the this strategy. The stock crossover. And then on this dialog we click on view code. And here we can see the two conditions with the orders to paint signals and execute orders. Now we are going to convert this into an indicator. The process is something, it's a little different from how it was on Ninja 7. So now we go to indicators, right click, new indicator. Click on next. We select a name. This name must be different from the strategy because each code must have a different name. We select if calculating at var close or intravar, if we need additional data or if we use a special function. And now we specify the input parameters. It is better to specify the input parameters from here, so we don't need to copy the code. Here we only need two parameters, the period and the smoothing, because the target and the stop are not used. So I will add the same input parameters with the same name and with the same default settings, the period and the smoothing. Here we can define if we want to plot a line. On this example, we don't need to plot anything, any line, because we are only drawing arrows. So we leave this on blank. And now we can finish and we get a code with part of the logic. We have the input parameters and some of the variables. So now we can copy what is missing from the strategy code. Here we can see the default settings on the strategy and on the indicator. This part of the code is not used, the target and stop. But here we have the stochastic definition that we must copy and paste it below the last condition. And now we need to copy the section of the on bar update. We copy all the code and paste it inside the on bar update section. We need to comment the orders because on indicators we cannot use orders. And now we can try to compile to check if everything is fine. And we get an error because stochastic one is not defined. So maybe on the strategy code we have somewhere like here where we define the stochastic variable. Just below the first, below strategy, so we place this below indicator. Just before on state change. So now it compiles. And now we can test the indicator. I will disable the strategy. And now I will add the indicator. We can see the two input parameters. And the first thing we see is that we are adding an extra panel. And also only the two last signals, not all of them. The additional panel can be configured from the input parameters. We can change, instead of using the panel number 3, using same as input data series, But we can also set this by default on the code, where we have is overlay, we can set this to true. So I compile again, remove and add the indicator again. To check if we have fixed the additional panel trouble, adding the indicator again, and now we don't get the extra panel. So we only need to fix the remaining signals, not just the last one. If we look at the code, we can see where it paint arrows, the name of the signal is unique. It is not using a counter. Each signal needs to have a unique name. So we can add the number of the bar, which is unique for each bar. This was done automatic on Ninja 7, but on Ninja 8 we must add this manually. So we add the current bar to the name of the signal, we compile again, and now we can reload the Ninja script, and now we can see that we get all the signals painted. If we double click on a signal, we can see that each marker has a different unique name that contains the number of the bar. Hope this video has been useful for you, and if you have any question, please post below this video. Thank you everyone, bye bye.